Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. I want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas tomorrow. Today is Christmas Eve, December 24th, 2022, and it is Saturday. At 1:01 a.m. local time, there in British Columbia, off of Graham Island, there was a magnitude 4.7 and a 4.1 earthquake. USGS said they were a magnitude 4.5 and a 4.0. I downloaded two different sites. Here is the magnitude 4.7, and we'll go to the seismic signature. And let me bring it up so you can see the stations. Okay, we got Canada, DIB, and BNAB. Here's the earthquake information from Earthquake Canada. You can see we got a magnitude 4.7. And it occurred at 1:01 Pacific Standard Time. Now they're saying no damage has been reported and none would be expected. No tsunami is expected either. Now USGS gave it an intensity level 5, and this is from people that reportedly said they felt the earthquake. Felt by most people, some breakage of dishes, maybe windows, plaster in their homes, and tall objects would have been knocked over. You can see over here, now that would be between a 3.5 and a 4.0. And let me bring this up so you can see. This would be according to the Richter scale. Now being a 4.7, that would have been an intensity level of 6. Felt by all, many would have been frightened, run outdoors. Falling plaster and chimney damage would have been small. So I don't know if you guys got damage over there, but if you do, let me know. There is no moment tensor ball, so I'm just going to guess about this, that it's caused by the North American plate moving west. And you can see here we got the Cascadia subduction zone. I hope you guys are prepared for a large earthquake. You can see here in 1949 there was a magnitude 8.1. Also in 1977 there was a magnitude 7.7 in this same location. Further south, 1970, 7.4. And this red line drawn out is the Cascadia subduction zone. And then down here we got the Explorer plate right there. And there's been a lot of earthquakes showing up on the North American plate, showing that the plate is moving. And we're going to see more of that as the Earth's magnetic field weakens. They have stopped giving us information about just exactly where the magnetic poles are. And they stopped giving us information about what the strength is for the magnetic field. Now for the magnitude 4.1. Earthquake Canada says it occurred at 9:32. And it says here, approximate location of the earthquake. They got it on their little map. Lightly felt in Port Clements, Skidgate. There's no report of damage and none would be expected. And no tsunami is expected either. Aftershock of the recent earthquake. That would be the 4.7. On the USGS website, both of these earthquakes were fairly shallow, 6.2 miles below sea level, or as they put it, 10 kilometers. Now, USGS said that the 4.7 was a 4.5. 20 people sent in reports to USGS. And you here you can see the felt reports we got over here by Prince Rupert. And the strongest, it looks like, if I can get it to work, intensity level 4, doesn't give a name of the location. Let's see what we got here. Nothing there. Intensity level, let's see about Prince Rupert. Intensity level 3. The shaking, they said, was intensity level 3. Which means it was felt noticeably there in Prince Rupert, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing automobiles rock slightly. Vibration like a passing truck. So there in Prince Rupert, they said it felt like a magnitude 2.5. But closer to where the earthquake occurred, which they don't give a name, intensity level 4. So they said that it felt like maybe a magnitude 3 or a 3.5. And again, maybe some breakage. Now for the 4.0, which 6 people said they felt, USGS said it was an intensity level 5. Looks like all the reports came from Graham Island, and this would be closer to that military base. Let me go back and show you. Masset, British Columbia military base. Let me go in. It was closed down, but then I heard reports that they were opening it back up because of all the recent drumbeats of war with you-know-who. Going to Street View on Google Earth, they only have a couple locations that I can view. Let me exit here. Okay, Nature Center. Let me come back out and we'll do that again with the Street View. Yeah, wooden structures hold up really good. Let me bring this out. Looks like over there. Just an area. We got a gate. And it looks like another wooden structure down the road, but that's as far as I went. Let me go back to Street View, see what area I see. There isn't very many places that I can view. Yeah, the sanctuary and the, I can't even view the buildings over here. But what I did notice, let me click out of this. Yeah, right there. Okay, let me come back. Yeah, we got a lot of marshes over here. And this area would probably just turn to quicksand in a large earthquake. Yeah, not good. So please be prepared for a large earthquake. Like I said, this is close to or along the Cascadia subduction zone. We're going the opposite direction. Let's turn it back towards North View. There we go. So did you feel them? Yeah, we don't want another Cascadia rupture. Can you imagine the damage up here and then down here, Washington, Oregon, and California, if that decided to rip? Everything west of the interstates would just be totally devastated and toast, as they said. And then there would be a mass migration of people moving east because there would be no water, no power, bridges would be out, your infrastructure would be totally wiped out. And it would probably be decades before it's rebuilt. So I want to wish everyone again a Merry Christmas. Please be prepared. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.